Described in many ways, written over many centuries. In religion, it is written that love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful or proud or rude. It does not demand its own way. It is not irritable, and it keeps no record of being wronged. It does not rejoice about injustice, but rejoices whenever truth wins out. Today, we are here to celebrate the distinct love shared between Nathan and Sarah. They have chosen to write their own vows to each other, which they will now exchange. Nathan?
Sarah, It's been 6 years since you came into my life, and when you did, I would never imagine that I would be here standing in front of you today. You have given me so much, and I cannot thank you enough for what you continue to give me every day. I promise that I will do everything in my power to make you happy and give everything that I have to make our future and our life together as wonderful as you deserve. I promise to stay true to you and to never take the love and the gifts that you've given me for granted. I promise that I will always share everything that I have and everything that I am with you. I promise that I will always be there to give you a foot rub or a back rub or any kind of back scratch that you need in an emergency. Most of all, I promise that I know nobody can be perfect, and I know I will never be perfect, but I promise that I will always love you with everything that I have and everything that I am, and I will love you through the difficult times, through the happy times, through every trial and tribulation that we have to go through in order to make our life together wonderful. You have given me so much, and your love and companionship is what makes my life worth living. And I cannot express to you enough how much I have to thank you for what you've given me and what you mean to me. I promise that I will never take you for granted and always love you.
Sarah? I guess it's fitting that we're all getting wet today, since on our first date, I was pretty sure I was going to drown, and it was going to be the worst first date ever that you'd have to call my mom and tell her that I died. But I didn't. That was 2 years, 10 months, and 9 days ago, and I've been thinking about what I might say to you in this exact moment for about 2 years, 10 months, and 8 days. And you'd think with that much practice and time, I'd have the perfect vows, but I don't. I don't think that there are the perfect words that express how I feel about you. So for now, the best I can come up with is to say, thank you for the love you've given me. I promise to spend the rest of my life proving myself deserving of it.
Ready for the ring? Nathan, if you'll repeat after me. I give you this ring as a symbol of my unending love and devotion.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my unending love and devotion.
May its presence on your hand serve always to remind you of my love.
May its presence on your hand serve always to remind you of my love.
Sarah, repeat after me. I give you this ring as a symbol of my unending love and devotion.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my unending love and devotion.
May its presence on your hand serve always to remind you of my love.
May its presence on your hand serve always to remind you of my love.
Will all of you gathered here today do everything in your power to preserve this marriage? Will all of you who have known these two in friendship and in love now give your blessing upon them and do everything in your power to support them in their marriage? If so, please show your support by saying, we will.
We will.
We will.
We will.
Enthusiastically,
we
will.
We will.
We will.
Okay. We will.
Nathan, do you take Sarah as your wife? As your companion and best friend for life, will you treat her with love and devotion, honor and respect? Will you stand by her in the triumphs and tragedies of life as a faithful and caring husband?
I will.
Sarah, do you take Nathan as your husband? As your companion and best friend for life, will you treat him with love and devotion, honor and respect? Will you stand by him in the triumphs and tragedies of life as a faithful and caring wife?
I will.
Nathan and Sarah, since you have exchanged vows,
and promised one another your never-ending love, commitment, and loyalty, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Let me kiss you bride. Family and friends will present to you the new couple, Mr. and Mrs. Nathan Rum.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're like much more than I never knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
From the first time I saw you, I knew you'd be mine. From the first glance you gave, my world had slowed, you stopped the time. And in that moment I could see all of the things that we would be. You were the girl I was waiting for, that I would ask to marry me. Like the beauty of the sun, you light my life so I can see. Make me laugh and show me how, just how good this life can be. And in our moments filled with joy is where I live, where I am free. Lay in my arms, I hold you tight, just like you like continually. And I am overwhelmed by you. With joy, you've taken me higher and shown me what love can do. Where would I go or be without you? There's something in your smile that gives me strength to carry on. Something in your words that lingers even when you're gone. Oh, I've dreamt that a time like this would come for.